Here you have the Wyze app. When you first log into it, you can see I have two separate plugs. Anytime you add a new plug or a new item, it will always go to the top here. You can toggle your plug on and off, and there you can see the light turning on and off to the side. Now, the app itself, I will say, was originally designed for the Wyze cameras. So they kind of cannibalized and built upon the app for these extra things, such as the plug. So down here, these are all pretty much related to the Wyze cams. That's your shopping, that's your account. So let's actually just pop into the plug to see what you can and cannot do. Actually, we're gonna go into this plug because this is the plug I use more often. So inside the plug, the settings are, you can turn it on or off, and that's toggling a plug nowhere near where we are currently. You have timer, which will allow you to, right here it says, turn plug on after X amount of whatever, or you can set it to turn plug off after X amount. It's fairly standard for a smart plug. You also have vacation mode, which will allow you to put this plug into a vacation mode. So what it will do is, will automatically turn on and off the plug as if you were home. Now, you don't get to set anything up there. You can also tell it to, don't show me this again, we're just gonna go turn on, and now vacation mode is on. You can see it's in green. If you wanna turn that off, you just click on it again. So, turn on and off. So, we'll randomly turn the plug on and off based on making it look like you're home. Here you have runtime. So today you could see it's been on for 59 minutes and it will show you exactly when it has been on. Nice little chart there. Average, I get about hour 45 because this is my bedroom light. So it's only on really in the evenings, but here it'll show you just about how long it stays on and, you know, give you a little graph and kind of help you figure out you're using your plug. Now keep in mind that this does not keep track of energy in any way, shape or form. It just tells you readouts of how long things have been on. Up here you have settings. Coming to settings, you can change the device name. So just like when you originally set it up, you can change the device name there. Plug status light. Now this is neat. I like this. You can turn that on or off. And since it's in my bedroom, I like to keep that off because while the status light isn't terribly bright, I don't want that on. Schedule automation. So Wyze allows you to set up specific scheduling. So for me, these are all things that I set up for my Wyze cam and Wyze cam pan to turn on and off based on specific days of the week. Now to set up an automation, you come up here, press the plus sign so you can create a schedule, a shortcut or a device trigger. In our case, just so you can see, we're going to set a shortcut and we will call this Wyze plug and select an action. Now from here, you would have to select either your basement or bedroom plug, so we're gonna go that, and we're gonna select turn on or off. We're gonna say turn off and hit save, and now we have a trigger that will add a shortcut to our main menu. Now we are gonna discard all that because I really don't wanna have that on my main screen. I prefer to use my voice to activate the plugs or the button on the device. Share, well, if you had somebody else with a Wyze account, you could share access to specific things using this. Now, if you press on share, you would have to know their email address in order to do that. Device info is just that. It tells you all the device info. It will allow you to update directly from there. However, when an update is pushed, it does automatically show up on the launch screen when you enter the app. And that really is the Wyze plug. The rest of the app is really meant for a lot of the other things, the Wyze Sense, the Wyze Bulbs, and the Wyze Cam. They pretty much are making their own little ecosystem now. So if you're interested, I'll put a link over there to one of the Wyze Cam videos that I've done so that you can get an idea of other things that the app can do. This was mainly just to show you what the smart plug application could do.